Excuse me. I'm told to tell you that Anna's here listening, but she's just not on.
Now tell her just to keep making that guac and send me up some.
There you go.
So real quick, guys, a few new faces on here that have not necessarily gotten to interact with Jeff, Sean, Trina, Peggy, and Shane. You guys, hey Trina. For you guys, Jeff's my partner out of St. Louis. Runs the Fitzer region. It's Jeff Fitzer. And he's got teams all over the country now, and he spends a good part of his time teaching on social media, video, branding. Obviously, branding, you see he's always wearing different hats and shirts, and this is one he had made for USA Mortgage that I'm wearing, so he's got me on the train. He's just been a great mentor for me, and you guys have seen me more active on social media with the videos and stuff, and that's been a big part of a lot of the reason that I came over to USA Mortgage was for all the stuff that he's doing. And he was awarded a top five influencer by BombBomb. And he's too kind of humble to talk about some of this stuff. So he gets right into the training. I don't want to waste any more of your time with fluff, but for those of you that have not gotten a chance to see him on Facebook or interact at all, he's amazing, super responsive. So if you have questions, you can always reach out to me, but they'll always message you back on Facebook too if you have questions. So Jeff, without further ado, take it away, my man.
Thank you very much. I am going to share my screen, and I am going to try to actually do some live interactive sharing my cell phone screen, if it works. We'll see if it works. But do you guys see on my screen now the Y video is vital?
Yes. Yeah.
All right, cool. So I am going to go through this presentation. A lot of you already know me. Some of you may have seen some of this stuff, but some of it's timeless, so I include it. And so bear with me on that, but there's a lot of new stuff in here as well. I'll breeze through the introduction, but I'm just going to go ahead and get started here with the presentation in just a second. All righty. Can you guys hear that?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Video tip number five. Remember when I told you in video tip number one that you should change your backdrop to kind of keep the audience guessing? Well, I'm taking a page out of Noel Nielsen's book and going very bold with this backdrop. So shooting a video in the shower or bathtub might be a little over the top, but the point of video is to catch your audience's attention. So maybe this is a little too bold for you, but I think you get the point.
How many of you guys have seen that video before?
I have.
I have not.
Jeff, why are you watching shower videos of me? It's funny. So usually I'm doing this on stages, right? Or doing it in front of you. Some of you have seen me talk when I was down in Wellington or West Palm last year. And I always lead with that video because it does grab the audience's attention. And that was the point of it. That was a part of a 12 video series I did. I guess it was beginning of 19. Just kind of giving tips on what you can be doing for your videos. Ironically, we just did 14 days of video, which I'll tell you a little bit more about later. I always start with that because it does grab the audience's attention. It is a great hook for videos. You've seen it in real estate videos since. It's become very popular. Showers, bathrooms, bathtubs, all that kind of stuff. And I start this presentation with kind of an intro about who I am. But most of you know me, so I'm going to jet through this. But the reason I bring it up every time that I do speak is because, first of all, I never know if somebody's going to be on that doesn't know me. Second, there's so much power in video, and I am the living, breathing proof of that and what it's done to create opportunities. Number one, obviously, I wouldn't even be speaking to you guys if it wasn't for video and social, because that's how David found me. And that's how so many people found me. And those of you I know, like Jeff Hall is a great example, who does follow me, I bet he could probably tell somebody more about me than some of my closest friends and family just because he follows me. And that is the power of social media. And I get that all the time. And it's like I said, it's done massive things for my career. And so the reason why I say that is not to brag, but to say, imagine if you implement this even at just a micro level, both number one in terms of content, but also in just dialing in on a local area and just sharing more stuff, just creating more content. So for me, it's obviously led to a bunch of lab coat agents connections, speaking as I'm doing to you, our local Club Wealth, as David said, top 30 video influencer in 2019 as per BombBomb in the United States and Canada, which is probably one of my most proud awards I've ever received. Just because it's been very validating, because I take a lot of crap for a lot of the videos that I've done over the years, because a lot of them are very authentic and very personal. And a lot of people say, well, I don't get it. I don't understand why you're doing that. Why wouldn't you talk about real estate or talk about mortgage? And the answer is, and we talked about this last week, is because I'm playing the algorithm game. I'm playing the game of getting more eyeballs. I'm playing the game of wanting to get seen more often. And so I put content out that I think my audience wants to see, and I play it based on the engagement. And that's what I encourage you guys to do. Now, this talk today about video is gonna be very specific to real estate. And I'm gonna dial in on what you need to shoot video, kind of how to shoot video. We might even show some examples if I can get my screen share to work. And I'm gonna show you a bunch of examples that I've created at various listings. And then most recently, which a lot of you, some of you may know about this, some may not, I'm really excited about this. We just launched this yesterday called Business Video School. It's a virtual video school, literally. And it's designed to be in group settings. Originally, we were designed to put it out to brokers to basically be a value add for brokers. So for like your KW office, you know, maybe your brokerage would get it and then charge you back a small fee to have access to the curriculum. We just announced it. I do have some information if you guys want it. I'm happy to share it with David, who can share it with you guys. It's just another value add. And I'll be honest, the reason this came about, one, I'm passionate about video and I really believe in what it can do because of what it's done for me. Two, there's a gap. Like, nobody's really teaching video at a consistent high level with a curriculum. Like, there's people like me that speak about it, but that's just kind of giving you a snippet or an overview. Whereas we really wanted to create something, and I partnered, I kind of became friends with this guy who started the school, who's a local guy to St. Louis, so I'm lucky there. But I did it because I wanted to bring value to my real estate agents. Turns out he was working on something and he wanted me for the influence. So it's kind of a win-win for both of us. And so just to be completely transparent with you guys on this call, the reason why I'm a part of this is because I want to have a differentiator, which is the whole point of video, but I want to have a differentiator for our business. This is just one of several that we've created that we want to provide to you real estate agents to basically help you grow your business. That's our whole goal. So I'll get you more details on that. This is not a sales pitch for that by any means. I'm just excited about it. It's brand new and it's new, so I wanted to share it with you. So let's get into the why of video. And there's a million reasons why you should do video, and most of them are pretty obvious. But one of them that doesn't get talked about a lot is this: parasocial relationships. And a lot of people don't even know what the hell this means. You know what it means, but you don't know what it means. And the technical term, the description is, it's a one-sided relationship where one person extends emotional energy, interest, and time, and the other party doesn't know they exist. AKA like famous people or characters in a book or characters in a TV show. You know, it's like, I feel like I have a really strong connection with Maverick and Top Gun, but Maverick doesn't know who the hell I am. Tom Cruise doesn't know who the hell I am, but I feel like, you know, he and I have done a lot of things together. We've had conversations together. I know him well, but he doesn't know who I am. And that's a parasocial relationship. And historically, that has only applied to the movies and to TV and to radio and to books. But now it really applies to the world that we live in, which I touched on last week, and I'm not gonna do it again. But the opportunity that we have on social media to create these parasocial relationships and understanding that that is the point of why you're using video is critical for you. Because again, you want your audience, the people in your communities, to get to know you better. And so it's not just about creating real estate content. It's just about getting in front of the camera more often and sharing your life. And that creates the parasocial relationship. Whereas, like I said, a Jeff Hall or somebody like that, who probably knows me way better than he ever could have known me if it wasn't for social media. I mean, I guarantee it. Even if it was my neighbor, Jeff Hall knows me way better than all of my neighbors because I don't even associate with them. too busy on social media all the time. It's funny how that works. And so this is the point. I've got a couple of images that were kind of funny that I think some of you can relate to if you read books. I'm in a complicated relationship with a fictional character, so true. And this one spells it out perfectly. The fan is, I feel as if Harry Potter is a real friend of mine, and Harry Potter saying, I don't know who the hell you even are. And that's the point. And you guys, a lot of you have heard me say this. I said it last week. Usually not a week goes by for me that I don't have a conversation with a real estate agent or a broker or somebody on a national level who will tell me, I know you, you don't know me. In fact, I just got a text over the weekend, a Facebook message from someone. I need to share it. It's a great testimonial who said, he started off by saying, you don't know me, but thank you for all that you do for our industry. It's amazing, all the content, blah, blah, blah. That is the parasocial relationship. That is me winning parasocial relationships. And that's exactly what you all need to be doing in your business to really take it to another level, to make your business more sustainable rather than constantly chasing leads. This is how you create business coming to you and people remembering you more often. And it is all about doing video. I shared some of these stats last week. I added a couple to it. This is relevant to this, so I included the slide. So those of you who were on last week saw some of these. Obviously, you know, people want to work with people doing video, 85% to be exact. Homes listed with video get 4 times the inquiries of homes listed without. The email opt-in, the click-through and opt-in on email is absolutely insane. Let's just be honest. People want to watch videos. They don't want to read paragraphs. Viewers retain 85% info through video versus 10% when reading in text. And the one that's so relevant right now, and I did validate that this statistic is accurate, traffic on Facebook is up 50% right now. Just a little plug for Lab Coat Agents. If you are not in Lab Coat Agents, I would suggest you get into Lab Coat Agents. They're actually interviewing Facebook tomorrow on a webinar. I'm gonna find who I need to mute there. There we go. Sorry. Who's your SOI seeing right now? Who is your sphere on social media seeing right now? So if you're not doing what Sherry's doing and creating videos, your competitor is, and they are going to be seeing your competitor. So it's so relevant right now. And I don't want to undermine that and say it's not relevant when we come out of this quarantine, because it is. It's probably more so than ever. But right now, like, people are forming habits right now. And the people that are at home are spending more time on social. That's a habit. So even though when you go back to leaving your house, you're going to have new habits on searching social media. And so does a lot of your sphere. And if you think that the world is not changing because of this, you're absolutely wrong. I'm not saying that we're not going to go back to, you know, live showings and meeting with buyers and putting them in our car and going and driving to listings. But there's going to be a lot of people that are changed as a result of this. And so there's going to be some people that say, you know what? I don't feel really comfortable going to see that open house. Can you just do a virtual tour for me? So if you can hone in those skills now, you're going to have more opportunity with more buyers and more sellers because you have that on your list, because that's something that you've gotten really good at. And so that's part of what I want to teach you today, because it's not all about hiring an expensive videographer, although we have one. We have one and a half, really. Actually, two and a half, really. It didn't start that way. And I still, to this day, shoot a ton of video with my cell phone using very basic tools. And I'm going to get into that next. So I just wanted to make sure I stressed that. So that leads me into, what do you need to shoot quality video? Do you need an expensive camera? Do you need to have a professional videographer? Do you need to have Adobe Premiere or Final Cut Pro? Do you need to have a Mac? The answer is no to all of that. You have access to pretty much everything you need, and the things you don't maybe have already, you can have for very inexpensive. First of all, you all have a cell phone. That's all you need. And if you have the iPhone 11, you've got probably you've got as good of a DSLR camera as you can in a cell phone. It's the best camera phone out there. And I know Android also makes a high quality phone. But in addition to that, these are the three pieces of equipment that I say you absolutely need. You need a tripod. This is my favorite tripod. I actually just bought it because my other ones went kaput. They just broke overuse. And I just found this one. It is, to be exact, $24.99 on Amazon. The reason I like it is because A, it extends to 5 feet like a lot of tripods do. It breaks down into very small. It easily fits in my backpack. Obviously, it turns, so you can go horizontal, you can go vertical. It has the extension. It's almost like a selfie stick. It actually kind of is, because as you can see here, it's got a little remote for selfie stick purposes. But the reason why I love the tripod, for the obvious reasons, for obviously stationary videos, but also if you don't have a stabilizer or you just don't feel like you can justify the expense of a stabilizer, which I do highly recommend, by the way, a tripod makes a big difference. One of the biggest no-nos, there's certain things that I just can't stand in videos, and I'm gonna go through all of them today, but one of them is holding your phone. Do not hold your phone at all, at most cost. You know, there are some cases where there's no other choice. Maybe you're at the Grand Canyon and you just don't have a choice. But in most cases, especially when you're doing professional listing videos, do not hold your phone. So either A, prop it up somewhere, B, use a stabilizer, or C, have a tripod and use the tripod as the way you hold your phone. For whatever reason, it holds it more stable, it's less shaky, plus it gives you more depth. There's nothing worse, there's no way around me having to see the pores on your face or look up your nostrils when you're holding your phone. So don't do it. Get one of these tripods. I actually have three. Why? Because I don't ever want to forget it, because I don't want to be stuck in a situation where I need my tripod. So I have one at home, I have one at work, and I have one in my car. So I don't ever not have my tripod, because it makes a huge difference. So that's number one. Number two, lighting. Lighting is extremely important, and lighting covers a lot of different things. There's a lot of different ways you can get lighting. I use this one because it's a very simple tool that's fairly inexpensive. This is a $47 tripod with a cell phone stand, ring light, also a tripod, obviously, as you can see. But this is very effective for pretty much anything you need to do. Ring lights are useful for obviously talking head videos. You can use them in a studio, like if you had a green screen. You can just use them for lighting if you're like on a Zoom call at night. What I recommend with a ring light is make sure you set it up high enough to where it's not eye level with you, but it's like shining down on you. So unless you're doing like a specific video where you're looking directly like it's set up right now, you can just use it as a light. But that way it doesn't put a ring in your glasses like it would for Jeff. If he had a ring light facing right at him, you'd see a ring on his glasses. It's not the end of the world, but if you want to get around that, you can. I know people that use these ring lights as their studio lighting, so they're very effective. And as you can see, they come with like soft lights, which is also pretty cool. Other options for lighting are, they have clip-on ring lights. I just saw the other day, they have a clip-on for your laptop. So like when you're doing a Zoom meeting at night, it just clips on the top and just shines a light on your face. So that way it's basically showcasing you, which is the whole point of lighting. And then of course there's the big fancy lighting that you get with like a green screen setup. It's not that expensive. You can get all that lighting set up for probably around $100-$150 if you wanted to go crazy. But at the end of the day, all you really need is to know how to use this guy right here, is use the sun. So just make sure you know how to use the sun, because when you're shooting videos during the day, just always make sure that your camera or your laptop. So like right now, you can't see me, but I had to adjust the setup of my office to where the back of my computer is facing my windows. Therefore, my windows are facing me, because if I had it the other way, then my face would be a complete shadow. And if I had it right or left, which I had before, there was a constant shadow on one side of my face, or a constant light on one side and shadow on the other. Not the end of the world, but having quality lighting makes a big difference. And so just adjusting where the sunlight is on your videos makes a big difference. And when you're outside, so let's just say you are doing a video outside and you're holding your camera or you're holding your phone with a tripod, of course, make sure that you adjust to where you're standing, to where the sun is shining on the back of the phone, on the camera, so that it's shining on you. It's showcasing you. That's the whole point. Just know how to use natural light. That's all you really need for the most part on videos. And then the last thing is audio. Obviously, audio is very important. It's the third thing for a reason to me, because most of our cell phones, really all of our cell phones, audio quality is very high. It's very good. So most of your videos, most people are shooting them in solitary areas, quiet areas, because A, you just don't like doing video in front of people. So you don't really need anything for that. But when you are shooting them, like when you're doing interviews or you're shooting them maybe in a park or in a public setting, invest in a lavalier microphone. I actually stumbled upon this one yesterday. I've got a bunch of these. But most of them require an adapter. So the little pluggy deal here that goes into your phone, this one comes with that little pluggy guy. This is on Amazon for $27.99. So I like it. I'll probably get it because I always lose my adapters, my iPhone adapters. So this is kind of cool. I like it. The other one that I highly recommend is this interview set. A lot of you have seen, like, for example, David's doing these interviews where he interviews businesses. And that's the worst. And it's so common, which the concept is great. You go into a business, you go into a restaurant because you want to highlight a business. You want to, you know, give back to the community and give good content. But they don't have a lavalier microphone set like this. And the audio sometimes is muffled or sometimes it's hard to hear. And so just investing $35 in an interview set like this makes a big difference. Obviously, if it's two people, it's easy. It's already got a splitter. It plugs into your phone and you get two audios, right? If you have multiple people, what I've done is I'll clip the interview or I'll clip the microphones to something to just where it's close to us, to where it's easy, where all of us can pick up our sound. You just got to get creative with this. But this is a super inexpensive, awesome piece of equipment that any one of you should just carry around. I literally keep this in my backpack because I never know when I'm going to need it. And so I highly recommend that. So those are the biggest pieces of equipment that I recommend for video. The last thing that all of you should invest in at some point in time, and most of you know this guy, this is a videographer. So this is my videographer. It's kind of a creepy photo, but that's what he sent me. This is Papa. David knows Papa. Some of you know Papa because he came with me to Florida. He usually travels with me. But I recommend, I know that a small percentage of professionals in any sales industry are going to have a full-time videographer. That's just unique, right? You build up to that level. That's when you know your next level, when you have a full-time videographer. But you don't need one full-time, but you do need to invest in them from time to time. So when you have that super high-end listing, do not do what I'm going to show you today. That's for the average listing. But when you have those million-plus dollar listings, invest in a videographer, make a sexy video, and all of you should have like an evergreen commercial for yourself, a branding video, maybe multiple ones. Those are the reasons why you would hire a videographer, and you can hire them on retainer, you can hire them per project. They're becoming a dime a dozen. There's tons of videographers out there because the world's going to need more of them going forward. So just know when you need it and when you don't. So that leads me to the next piece of quote unquote equipment. Well, which is apps. And these are my favorite apps that I use for video. And I've used all of them, almost all of them, in the video examples I'm going to show you guys today. First things first, on the left side here is iMovie and WeVideo. So iMovie is the editing platform that comes on your iPhone. And I'm going to actually try to show you some examples if I can. WeVideo is the equivalent for Android. Everybody asks me every time. So I've just asked enough people and they say that's the biggest equivalent to iMovie is WeVideo. It's pretty easy to use. Then there's Vimily. I love Vimily because it adds, the reason I like it, it's an editing software, but the reason I like it is because I can add banners on my videos. So you've seen videos where there's a banner on the top and the bottom or the right and left, and it basically can kind of give a title to whatever your video is about, which is eye-catching, which grabs attention, which people know then, okay, why should I watch this video? Well, because Jeff has headlines on it. So I like Vimily. It's very, very easy to use. You just upload your video into Vimily and you can add it. That's actually the free version that allows that. The only thing that sucks about the free version is there's a watermark of Vimily on your video. Personally, I could care less. But for those of you that do care about that, you can get the paid version, which is still fairly inexpensive, and you can add your own logo on all of your videos, which is pretty cool as well. Record It is another good one. That's a screen share app. Now, most of your phones come with this. And it's functional and it works, but I sometimes have a problem with it recording my audio. So I like Record It because it's easier. And, you know, so for example, if I'm sharing like an Instagram hack tip, or I'm showing sharing with a borrower or a customer, I want to show them my app, how they can do a home search, or how they can apply for their mortgage, or how they can follow along in their mortgage process, I can do a screen record and walk them through what I'm doing on my screen. And it's an awesome way to differentiate yourself and use video to stand out. That's Record It. Rev is a transcription service. It's rev.com. It's a website. So as most of you know, I think it's like 80 or 85% of videos on Facebook are watched without sound. So transcribing your videos and having the text written of what you're saying is important. Admittedly, I don't use it as often as I should, but rev.com is super easy to use. You just upload a video. It's $1 a minute. So if you have a 5 or 10 minute video, it costs you $5 or $10. It's some VA in some country, I assume. It's about 98% accurate. The only misspellings they ever have are usually name misspellings, which I can live with. It doesn't bother me that much. But it's very good. It's an awesome service. You usually get them back within 24 hours, depending on the length of the video. BigView is another app that we use for one, green screen. So you can easily shoot green screen videos on your mobile device. But it also has a feature, a teleprompter feature. So if you want to really put out a very crisp, dialed in script on your video, not an authentic one, which I recommend that most of the time. But let's just say I was putting out a recruiting video just to a prospective realtor that I want to join my team. I might write out a script and then let it play on the teleprompter. So I'm literally, it's playing just like the newscasters see it on the news, where they're seeing it on their screen and you're basically reading it, but the viewer doesn't know you are. So that's pretty cool. BigView is pretty awesome. It also comes at a nominal cost. I have the free version. I don't use it that often, but I just like it because of its features. InShot I've used to add licensed music. This is a tricky one because obviously licensed music is something that usually will get muted on the social media websites. So even if you own the music, like you bought it through Apple, you usually will get muted. So if you're using licensed music with the lyrics, so if you're using just the audio of a song, you're okay. But if you're including lyrics, Facebook and Instagram and YouTube will mute it almost every single time. That's another reason why I like TikTok, because it's allowed. But InShot's awesome. So if you have internal videos and you want to add a song, a popular song to it, InShot's a great place to do that. And I like it for that reason. You can also do that through iMovie as well. Once you get those skills. And iMovie does have generic stuff as well, generic sound. And then of course, Boomerang. The reason I like Boomerang is because it's one of the easiest apps to use for a novice. And so you're uncomfortable with video, but you have closings and you do the obligatory closing picture. Boomerangs make those closing pictures stand out more. It's just a little acting, two or three second loop of a video. And so instead of everybody just standing there with their arms around each other saying congratulations, you're all waving. And you know, most of you are probably familiar with Boomerang. If you're not, get familiar, it's easy. And it's just something different that will make your closing pictures, for example, stand out. It's fun to use. So that's it for the apps. Those are what I use. There's a million other apps out there. That's just my recommended ones because I have experience with them. And then I wanted to dive a little bit deeper into iMovie. So I am going to, I'm going to show you some clips here. Most people, when they think of video editing, they look at this picture on the left side and this is what they picture. Like multiple screens and all of this just gibberish, like looks Chinese to us. It's like, we wouldn't even know what to do with it. But what I want everyone to understand is that you have two functions that you have easy access to. One is actually in your camera. So the one thing, so I gave you one tip previously on what not to do, like don't ever hold your camera. The other tip, the second tip, there's multiple tips, that I don't ever want to see in videos is when you're going in to push the play button or push the end button on your videos. You should never do that. Even if you have no editing skills whatsoever and no desire to learn editing skills, in your camera on your phone, when the video is done and you go to your camera roll, there's an edit button you can click, and then you can squeeze in the end and the beginning and the end to get rid of that. And that all of your videos should start with you in the beginning with your hook, which we're going to get into that later. But all of your videos should be like that. So if nothing else, if you take nothing else from editing today, take that. Make sure you understand how to edit with that feature. Now, I showed you a couple images, and David wants me to try to get into iMovie, but I think I'm going to save that till the end, just because I want to make sure we have enough time. I shared these images for an example, for two reasons. One, I do teach iMovie editing, and David has these skills too, and I'll allude to that here in a second. But we actually do a training on iMovie editing. And this is an example of, it's called homework assignment, because when I do these editing classes, I literally give the class a script, an assignment to go home and do this video, edit it, and post it to social. So I give you a script that's specific for you. It's good content for you to share to social media. And I design it so that the script is broken into five pieces. I want you to shoot five separate lines, play, say your line, stop. Play, say your line, stop. So that way, as you can see on the right side here, you have these different shots, different cuts of your audio. And then I teach you how to go through and edit that video and put it together. And you would see if I was doing the class, I actually videoed myself in one of my classes, and the people were laughing in the background because I kept screwing up, which was great because it's authentic, it's real. We're all human. I do a crap ton of videos, but I still mess up all the time. And having the skills to be able to edit my videos in iMovie is so easy to learn. I was taught by a 13-year-old. This was several years ago, and you can do it too. These are very basic editing skills, and iMovie has it to where you can now edit out your ums, or you can, if you screw up, you can just stop, pause, start over again, and then you can go back into iMovie and edit it out. It's that easy. iMovie's features are basically that. So the editing, you can start, you can do slow-mo, you can speed up, that's kind of fun. You can add sound, you can turn your audio down. So if like you're in a park and you're hearing birds, but you want music to play, you can turn down the audio on your sound and turn up the audio on the music. You can add text, you can add filters, and obviously you can do transitions. So this little guy in between those videos is a transition. You can play around with transitions, which is kind of fun as well. And if we have time, I'll get into that. But what I want to point out to everyone is that you all have access to an iMovie expert. I don't usually get to say this. And being that a lot of times I speak to agents, it's all over the country. I can't touch and feel you guys, and I can't sit and meet with you, but you guys have one. David actually taught me some stuff in iMovie. So you have your guy right there. If you want to learn how to do iMovie, he is your guy. I know a lot of you saw this one the other day where he did his son's haircut. That was fun. Obviously he does a whole heck of a lot of bomb videos and videos that he puts out to his clients. I have no idea what the hell he was doing on the floor here. He was probably searching for a crack in the floor. And then obviously on the right side, these are videos that he's doing, the Wellington highlights, which is also very cool. And a lot of that, I know he started by using an iPhone and doing iMovie, which is really cool. And all of you can do that, and he can teach you how to do it. And he can even do it with you. Because he can tell you exactly how that strategy works. And I recommend it. So do not forget about that. Next is distribution. This is obviously extremely important. If you have the videos, how are you going to get them seen? I don't need to talk too much about social. I will mention it, but this is what's really most important to me on video. You know, a lot of people tell me, well, I'm not creative like you are, Jeff, or I just can't come up with, I'm not funny. And so that's why I don't do video. And I say, well, what about BombBomb and sending out videos via text and email to your clients? Like replacing text emails or texts by putting a video out to where you can show emotion and you can display tonality. And a lot of times you can explain things better in a video than you can type it in an email. Plus, if you have to write a 2-paragraph or 3-paragraph email, how many times is it not even going to get read because people's attention spans are the size of a gnat? So using a service like a BombBomb or using video, if you only use it to communicate to your clients, man, you are doing something that most aren't, and it's a differentiator because your client gets to know you. Even though you may not be doing a video to tell them about your family life, they get to see you and hear you and just feel the emotion that comes from you versus what you're putting into a text. And so I highly, highly recommend getting a service like BombBomb. There are other ones out there. I'm clearly partial to BombBomb because we use the hell out of it. I mean, we use the hell out of it because we love it. And it's had a big impact for our business as well. And we literally pick up clients as a result. Somebody who, you know, for example, is shopping us with another lender. In your case, somebody's interviewing multiple agents for a listing or to be the buyer's agent. If you sent them BombBomb videos or sent them videos in replacement of text or email, I'm telling you right now, you're going to probably win those clients every single time because the other agents they're shopping are probably not doing that. And that client is going to get to feel and know you and have a stronger connection to you. It's powerful. Then, of course, there's social. Everybody knows this. I talk about this all the time. I'm not going to go deep on any of these because you all know it. I talked about it last week. These are the five that I use regularly. There's, of course, Twitter and Snap as well and Pinterest. Personally, I don't use it. Pinterest is probably a good one to be using just to create a following. Twitter is more news, in my opinion. It's harder to display that. And Snap is, there's really nothing. There's no use for business. It's really a text platform. But all of these platforms, you could be sharing content across. Obviously, you know, Facebook and Instagram, LinkedIn's a hell of a lot more professional. YouTube is just an amazing video platform. And TikTok is a beast in and of itself. And we talked about that last week. And I'll go a little deeper if I can today. The last thing before I show you examples is your video structure. Anybody who knows me knows, like, this is the piece that I'm most passionate about. I can't stand it when people hold their cell phones. I hate it when they have crappy sound. I've told you some of the nuances that I can't stand. One of the things that drives me the most nuts on videos is when people start their video with a, "Hey, it's Jeff here," or "Hey, happy Tuesday," or "Hey guys." Like, you have 3 to 5 seconds to capture the attention of your audience. 3 to 5 seconds. And they are scrolling social fast for the most part. And they're seeing a ton of real estate videos. So if you open up your video with that, that literally is taking up your 3 seconds and you're screwed. You're gonna lose the majority of the potential viewers that you could have. So having a hook on all of your videos, I don't care if it's personal, I don't care if it's your kid's ball game, I don't care if you're standing in front of a listing, I don't care if you're going live to talk about politics, which I wouldn't do, or you're going live to talk about the coronavirus, it doesn't matter. Always lead with a hook. Give your audience intrigue, tell them what's coming. You wanna grab their attention, you wanna tease them, maybe ask a question or make a bold statement. Something that's gonna make me stop in my shoes and say, all right, I wanna know what this is about. And so, you know, just for an example on a listing video, and I'm gonna give you a bunch of them here in a little bit, but just as an example is when you're standing in front of that listing, instead of saying, "Hey guys," or instead of introducing yourself first, you know, what's unique about that new listing? Or what's unique about the open house? What is it that a potential buyer is gonna be most interested in? Is it a new kitchen? Is it a huge backyard? Is it a finished basement? What is it? And so that's how I would lead that video, just to say, the huge backyard in this house is a great place for a family to just cut loose. And that's how you lead the video. "Hey, this is Jeff with XYZ Realty." That's how you should lead all of your videos. It doesn't matter what they are. And again, I'm gonna show you some examples, not all verbal, some visual. You can do whatever you want, just anything to grab their attention. Then, generally speaking, I would introduce myself. I would tell them who I am and who I'm with, just to remind them I'm a realtor or I'm a mortgage professional, whatever I am, but that's it. Just keep it very simple. This is the meat and potatoes of your videos. Tell a story, especially when it pertains to real estate. You know, I would try to find out when I have a listing and I'm gonna do a video about a house. Obviously, first you want to create intrigue with the features, with a feature or something special about the house. But then you want to try to get a story. You want to make an emotional connection to the viewer. And so, first of all, I would try to find out from the seller, like, what can you tell me about this house? Did you raise your family here? Does it have any historical facts? Is there something unique that happened here? Anything that can tug on a heartstring or make somebody want to watch this video and make them feel a connection to you and the home. That's what sells it. So make it interesting, definitely make it personal and bring value. And of course, facts are important, but always tell the story. Your stories are gonna be the good chunk of the video, probably 60 to 70% of the video. And just make sure you have something compelling. Don't just ramble. Make sure you're prepared and you script and you're on top of it. And then lastly, always have a call to action. There's gotta be something for them to do. Like, "Hey, there's gonna be an open house this weekend. This house goes on the listing in 1 week. You do not wanna miss out, it's gonna sell fast." Or get them to take action, you know, ask them to reach out to you for more information. If it's a social post, ask for engagement, ask for comments, ask for likes, whatever it is, or give them a place to go, give them a link to a landing page, give them a link to go to your website, give them a link to go somewhere so they can see more. And of course, always create FOMO. You know, you want, when you're selling anything, you want to make somebody feel like they have a fear of missing out. And so make sure that you create that fear so that they have to act. That's the whole point of a call to action. And so just work on that. That's something that I'm always happy to help. Anybody who does video at a higher level can easily give you advice. It's actually funny. Recently I had an agent in Florida call me and saying, "I'm here at a listing." And then she FaceTimed me and said, "What should I make my hook?" And so I literally just helped her walk through it. It was very easy. It had a view of the bay or the ocean. And I was like, "Gosh, there's your hook. It's a visual hook. Easy. That's going to grab my attention." And so I'm always happy to do that with any of you if you struggle with coming up with hooks, or if you're that person that gets on camera and every single time just vomits an introduction or vomits, a "Hey guys," that's what I would stay away from. Try to improve your videos with hooks. So let's move in and show you guys some examples of what I'm talking about. And some of you may have seen a couple of these before. I've shared them before. They're just kind of timeless and people like them, so I keep them here. But I'm going to show you what all of you do. Anybody who shot a video, either a live video on Facebook or social, or just a listing video, open house video, you've done this. And there's so many things wrong with it. I'm not going to make you watch the whole thing, but I'm going to show you, I'm going to point out a few things that I'm doing wrong intentionally here and what a lot of you do. First things first, look how close it is to my face. Well, and the reason is because I'm holding my phone. That's why you don't do that. I can see pores on my face. I can see that my nose has been broken a few times. I don't like any of that. And I don't think anybody really likes to see that either. So here we go.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Pitzer here with XYZ Realty, and I'm standing in front of 123 Main Street.
So I didn't speed it up because I'm telling you to speed up your videos. I sped it up because this is like a 4 or 5 minute video and it's painful to watch the whole thing. And so many of us, so many realtors put these videos out, and I'm already stopped watching because I don't want to go do another walkthrough, but I'm going to make you watch a little bit of it because this is what we all have to endure and what you've probably done before.
Here, the main entrance here, you've got the office. Pretty nice.
So this video sped up to hyperspeed. Like, this is like videographer hyperspeed. You can't even do this on your cell phone. It's still a minute and a half. So the regular video, like I said, was about 5 minutes long. And this is what we're inundated with on social media when we're shooting videos on our own. And it is just absolutely painful. My recommendation is just stop doing it. And I'm going to give you some examples of what you could be doing with what you already have at your disposal. So here is another video. This has a visual hook. So this is the one I did last fall. So some of you have seen this. This is an example of where I was intentionally going out to a listing to create content, just to use it as a teaching tool. And I had the agent send me pictures of the house, and I saw that there was a basketball hoop in the front yard. And I immediately thought, oh, this is going to be an awesome visual hook. And I'll show you what it looks like. Now, this video, there's three things that I did that I want to share with you that I think you should do in all of your videos. The first one is the visual hook. The second one is I added music through InShot. Now, I used licensed music for this one, so if I shared this to social, I'd probably get muted. But then the last one is I branded the hell out of myself throughout this video, and I'm going to show you how, so we'll check this out. So all of that right there was, there was a ladder involved because I can't dunk a basketball. I know not everybody can do that, but this is just an example. I had a basketball, I brought it with me, so I came prepared. I had my tripod, I set it up, I shot two different angles, I zoomed in, I slowed it down, all using iMovie. This is all basic stuff here. There was not a videographer involved. I did have another human with me, because you'll see why, because he was the one walking around the house holding my phone and videoing me because I'm branding myself throughout this video.
Staring out into the night, trying to hide the pain. I'm going to the place where love and good don't ever cost a thing. In the pain, it feels a different kind of pain.
Okay, so as you can see there, obviously I use text as well, and I also am using a little humor in the video because I knew that would keep the audience's attention. because I know that if they stuck with it long enough to see me laying in bed, they're going to stick with it long enough to see me in a bathtub. They're going to see it long enough to see me sitting on a toilet. They're going to want to keep watching. And that's really the whole point. To me, video is way more powerful to branding and selling you as an agent and not selling a home. I said this last week. I say it all the time. I'm not even a real estate agent, but I know as well as you do, none of this marketing stuff sells most homes. Price sells home. You're basically selling yourself and your ability when you can do this kind of stuff. So creating content like this is going to make you stand out and going to make you memorable. And people who watch are like, that guy's funny. I like him. I want him to sell my house. David, did you have a question?
Yeah. So it was a little choppy on my end, just probably the internet connection via Zoom or something, in case anybody else had the same thing. So you mentioned that you branded yourself subtly. Was that just you wearing the USA Mortgage hat?
Well, yes, partially, but really branding myself as in every room they're watching this go through, they're reminded of me because I'm in it.
Right.
And so less about, obviously, they already know I'm a realtor. I don't need to, actually I'm not wearing a hat in a lot of them because really the point is constantly remember me. I'm your realtor. I'm in all the pictures. That's the point. It's less, and this one, it's just as much about the house as it is about me, but that's the point of video. You know, you're trying to create a brand that makes yourself memorable. So,
right. And obviously the people can see that this is the kitchen and it's got stainless appliances and it's got this and that. So pointing it out, you feel like is kind of redundant, right?
Yeah. But I added text because I didn't want to, you know, again, A, I want to show the features of iMovie, but B, it's important to let people know. So that way, if they really are interested in this house, they're paying attention. Like, ooh, what are all the features? I mean, I show every feature in this video. I'm not going to watch the whole thing, but from the laundry room to the finished base, everything, to the backyard, to the grill, everything. And that's, I just used a different way to make the same boring video a little bit more entertaining and intriguing and you know, consumable, basically.
Right.
Okay, so let's move forward. I'm going to show you guys some hooks. So I talk about hooks. I'm passionate about hooks. I've got about four or five examples here that I'm going to show you. So I went to a different listing. This is newer and created a variety of videos. This first video is actually a video. It's a minute and a half. I'm not going to show you the whole thing. This was all done in iMovie. There's two hooks. This is the first hook, a visual hook of it would be, you know, your sign. It's not obviously not my sign. I'm not a realtor, but I used somebody's listing. So I zoomed in on my sign. Then it's me giving a hook of what the listing is about. Notice I don't say anything about me. Now I will tell you the audio sucked on this one, but I intentionally left the audio in because I want to show you an example of why you need a lavalier microphone, because it was a windy day that day, but I just decided to leave it. I'm just going to show you the beginning of this so you get an idea of a hook, and I'm going to show you three or four more hooks after this one. So here we go.
A completely rehab home right here in Arnold, 4-bedroom, 2 full bath, 2 half bath, and a completely finished basement. Let's go check it out. I'm Jeff Fitzer with XYZ Realty Company, and I cannot wait to show you this house.
So the rest of it is just a walkthrough of the house with some iMovie music, with some sexy transitions, but you see how I did the beginning there. It started with my branding. Then it was me telling you exactly what you're about ready to get. This is exactly what this house, it's a completely rehabbed house. Because at the end of the day, I'm not creating these videos for video views. I'm not creating them to go viral. I'm creating them to brand myself as a realtor and potentially sell a house. So I want people to consume it who want to consume it. So I told them where the house was. I told them exactly the specs on the house. Then I told them who I was at the front door, all with various cuts. And that's all done in iMovie. So that was that one. Now I'm going to show you some examples of some hooks. So this is a listing I went to without any preconceived pictures or anything. I just went there knowing I wanted to create a listing video example. I wanted to create some hook examples with whatever I had because I just wanted to show you what you have at your disposal if you just use a little creativity. And B, I wanted to create some TikToks. I'm going to show all of them. But this is, so I've got three additional hooks. Here's one of them. This house was staged, so there was this book in the living room, and I created a hook out of it. Here you go.
it doesn't take a scholar to figure out that this new listing at 1888 Fox Point in Arnold is going to sell fast. So again, your audience is going to be looking at this. This is not like a dunking a basketball hook, or it's not a verbal hook as much as it is a, what the hell is he doing sitting in some random living room? And then I just tied it together. Very simple. The next two involve the lemons that were in the kitchen and just quickly came to me that, ooh, I can do something with this. So I created two different hooks. I'll show you what they are.
This new listing at 1888 Fox Point Arnold is no lemon.
Very simple. All I'm doing, so this is like, this would be the beginning of my video. So instead of doing what I did in the beginning of that video, I might put this in there because I want to grab their attention. Then I do the walkthrough of the house. The last one I had a little bit more fun with. I used to be able to juggle. I still can to a certain degree. So I took, I juggled lemons. You'll see what I do. But you'll see, I put some fun little circus music with it. And I actually, there's three different takes. I probably would have included them all because they're somewhat entertaining. And I think people would have stuck with my video as a result of this. This is just another example of using what I had in the house to create a unique hook.
This new listing at 1888 Fox Point Arnold is no lemon. This new listing at 1888 Fox Point in Arnold is no lemon.
So you can see there, just having a little fun with my audience to, again, create a hook, but kind of display personality and show them who I am. And so lastly, I want to go into, before if we have any time, which we may not, but I want to show you some TikTok examples. I talk about TikTok. I'm passionate about it. It's the next stop. It's the next platform. I told you all about it last week. Now I'm going to show you some examples. If you're not on TikTok, I encourage you to get on there, get familiar with it, and understand it. The key is to understand it. It is a platform that is really driven by the younger generations, but us older people are coming, and we're coming in droves, and we'll be there soon. And it will be a very relevant platform for real estate if it's not already. But I also use it less about selling homes on TikTok, but taking that content, which is amazing that you can create in TikTok, and posting it back to the other platforms till they get a ton of engagement. But I'm gonna show you some examples of some listings. Now, again, if I have time to show some editing, I actually did some screenshots here real quick just to show you what it looks like. I'm not gonna go in this in too much detail because I don't really know my audience as far as I don't know your editing skills, but this is just kind of an example of what your screens look like, because I know even David uses TikTok, but I know he's not using the editing features in TikTok. I can tell by watching his videos. And I wanna actually teach him how to do it, and I wanna teach all of you. But there's so many different things that you can do with TikTok. And I'll share this presentation with you, David, if people want it. This would require me going through it. And I think it's more important for me to show my TikTok. So if we have time, I'll go back to this and kind of show you what these screens represent and what you can actually, like what the features are. Super, super advanced, way more advanced than iMovie. And it's amazing. But here's some examples of stuff we've created. So I've got five TikToks. They're all 15-second TikToks. So my audience all knows it's very consumable. They know it's not going to eat a lot of their time. And they know because it came from TikTok, it's probably going to be halfway entertaining. So I'm going to show you some examples. This one's relatively basic, but it gets the point across in a very short amount of time. So I did two at this one listing and then three at another one, and I'll show you. Super simple, just creating a video that's going to tease my audience to make them want more. And I think that video does a good job of it. This one was way more advanced, but again, I go look at TikToks of non-real estate stuff and figure out how I can make real estate videos out of it. This is a great example of one. This is actually, it's 18 cuts in a 15-second video, so it was somewhat labor intensive. Without my daughter at the time, I wouldn't have been able to do it. I could do it today. But this one would have taken probably a good 30 minutes to an hour to put together. With her expertise, it probably took us about 20 minutes. But it was a great way to display like every room of a massive house in 15 seconds.
So you notice what I did there. I'm a big fan of constantly branding myself in these videos. I could have done that video without myself in any of those images. I could have just done images of the house. But again, what's the point? What are you doing? You're an entrepreneur. You're selling yourself. Sell yourself. Let people know. Be a constant reminder. So me bouncing into those videos, maybe that was a little over the top, but I wanted to get the point across because I wanted to somewhat entertain and remind people who I am and what I do. Here is a very basic, this is a very simplistic TikTok that I could teach anyone to do, but it's effective. 15 seconds gives you a little short walk through the house, and I can use licensed music without having to worry about it.
Dancing in the kitchen in the pale blue light. Only care in the world is that our kids are all right. Daddy loves mama and mama loves him. Tomorrow we get to do it over again. Smile and then baby take my breath away with the good Lord.
You can see how simple that is. If you learn how to do TikTok, you can literally create those videos in like 10 minutes. They're awesome. This one took a little bit more creativity. This is just how my brain works. But I decided to do what I call a garage door symphony. And you'll see in the text in my video, it's kind of creative. I enjoyed it and I got to use Top Gun's music, which was even more fun, which I couldn't do on any other platform. That's it. It's so simple, but yet kind of creative. And you notice what I said, if the garage doors are this cool, imagine the rest of the house. That's the kind of stuff that's going to get people following you and wanting to see more of what you have to offer. It's kind of the point. And then of course, the last one, because I can't help myself and I like to shoot videos in bathrooms and on toilets and in showers, I did another one. Same concept. This is me basically displaying that this listing has 4 bathrooms and it's fully rehab. So again, another way to display features of the house in a 15-second video. Oops, let's go back here. We don't want to miss that. You want to see me on the shitter, I'm sure. So, this, as you can see, was the same listing that I did. I did 3 TikToks, 1 listing video, and there was, I think, something else. I was there for less than 2 hours. And I created 4 or 5 pieces of content, all for this listing. Imagine, just think about that. Number one, it's great marketing. Number two, imagine having this in your arsenal. So when you go to your next listing appointment, you can say, look at all this content I create. Look how unique it is. Like, I am gonna get your house seen. I can promise you that. And so if you have this in your arsenal, if you learn how to do this stuff, man, it is a game changer. It makes, every time I do this speech, it makes me wanna become a realtor. So I think I could sell the hell out of houses. Lastly, I'm gonna finish up here with I shared this last week, but it never gets old. Document, don't create. Turn the camera on your life more often. Just create more videos so your audience can get to know you and like you without even actually knowing you. Gary Vee is the godfather of social media. If you don't follow him, he's a good guy to follow. You learn a lot from him, and he vomits so much content you can't even keep up. This is a quote from Papa. It isn't about making your lives about video. It's about integrating video into your lives. Kind of live that mantra. Most of you have seen this one, one of my favorite quotes. Your shitty video will outperform your competitor's absent video all day long. In other words, just create. I know somebody on this call said they were going to a vacant listing to practice today. I hope I gave you some ideas of things you can do. Work on that hook. Maybe get into iMovie, work on that. Get with David, he can help you. Just going out, and I love that. I love whoever said that because that's exactly what you need to be doing. Don't be, you know, if you're afraid of putting content out because you think it's going to be crappy, go practice. Go practice more often. But the reality is, a shitty video is still better than no video. And so just do it and do it more often. And then lastly, again, one of my favorite, I shared this last week, your vibe attracts your tribe, as always. Just be you. Don't try to be a fake person. Put out more authentic content. Just display who you are, how you dress, and the people who are most like you will be attracted to you, and you will find yourself not chasing business anymore, and it will just be coming to you. Most of you, I think, were already friends on social, but here's my handles. David, I want to stop it now and open it up to any questions, if anybody has any questions. And then if anybody has time and wants me to share any editing stuff, I'm happy to. Otherwise, I'll leave that to you as well. It's up to you, brother.
I'll just put something out there while anybody's unmuting or coming up with a question. So, you know, I'm friends with most of you guys on Facebook. I think almost everyone in here. And if you scroll my feed, you'll see the videos, the cheesy stuff I do with my family and whatever. And I know you guys get BombBomb videos from me. So I use BombBomb religiously. And, you know, everything that I've done for the most part has been an iMovie. Jeff and Anna, we think we talked about this last week. The video I did with them down in Palm Beach, we shot and edited on my iPhone. And we shot it in probably less than an hour all over Worth Avenue. And then the condo as well. And then we edited. It probably took us 40 minutes to an hour to edit, but we had a lot of footage. And we added text and we cut and we sped it up and we slowed it down. And that video got over, and we barely showed the condo. It was about the Palm Beach lifestyle because of the price point. And that video, I think, got over 1,000 views within like 24 hours. It was pretty nuts. So this stuff works, man. I mean, it gets you eyeballs, which is the end result, to get you in front of your sphere. And, you know, Jeff touched on it last week on the social Zoom. But, you know, the end goal is to get those eyeballs and have them engage you, hopefully with your call to action on there. Or if it's something cheesy and they just make a silly comment, you're going to show up more often in their feed because Facebook recognizes that algorithm, as do the other platforms, and it will continuously put you back in front of those people. So if somebody else out there is creating the content that you're not, and they happen to be a realtor, you guys always kick yourself when a friend or family member, you know, buys or sells with someone else. If that person is more engaged on social, creating more content, you know, getting more engagement, they're just staying in front of that person more than you. It doesn't necessarily mean they're calling every week saying, hey, do you want to list your house? Hey, do you want to list your house? So that's kind of the purpose of this whole thing, is it's not for vanity. It's not, you know, I don't post a picture of me, a video of me, you know, shaving my kid's head to say, look how great of a barber I could have been. You know, it was fun. I was doing it anyway. I set up my tripod. Edited it in 10, 15 minutes, added some text and posted it. It got a ton of engagement. So do that with your personal stuff. Jeff, make Greek salad and post it. You guys know Anna's Greek. Here's a picture of her making Greek salad. And, you know, Mindy, we've seen you on TV. We did a couple of years ago, we did the trailers. You guys can do trailers in iMovie too. That's super easy to do. And I can show you how to do that if you don't do a specific video. But there's just so much out there. So, you know, let us know any questions on iMovie and editing. I'm pretty good at it, and I'm happy to help. And I'm local, although I can't sit in front of you right now. But I can get on the phone and walk you through it pretty easily. So,
well, and somebody put in the comments, it was Mindy. And Mindy, if you want to unmute yourself and tell me what you want to see, I can jump in right now. My screen share is working. So if you want to see anything specific, tell me what you want to see, and I'm happy to share.
Hi. I'm still just downloading iMovie because I didn't have the software up. But so do I shoot something and then I upload it into iMovie and it'll kind of walk me through it? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, let me show you. So let me share my screen and feel free to stay unmuted and just ask questions. And you should be seeing my cell phone screen.
Yeah.
Right? So yeah. What you do is, so I'm going to go into iMovie, which is top right here. And
yep.
It opens up here, and you're going to, well, actually, I'm in one, so let me go back to the main page. So it's going to come up on this page, and you can see, obviously, a bunch of videos that I recently edited.
Okay.
But what you would do is you would click on the plus sign, which is going to then take you here, and you're going to choose movie, and it's going to open up your camera roll. So then you can go choose whatever you want from your camera roll, and so you can choose multiple images you can do images too, video or images. And then I'm going to take you back here to this homework assignment. So this is the one I use it as an example. So I had already uploaded these various. So like I said, I give this assignment. There's five different pieces to it. And it puts it in like this. So as you can see, it was five different videos shot that was supposed to be off one script, and it is. And so then I can take it and edit it together. So let's just say, so I'll play this. So you guys probably should be able to hear this, and I'll show you an example. So I'm gonna listen to this. So first of all, you can see me standing at my camera about ready to push play, right? So then I step back.
What am I saying? You will not believe what I'm doing today.
Okay, so that's my intro. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click on that one. You see how it highlighted in yellow? And you can do one of two things here. The easiest thing to do is just take the left or right side where it's a darker shade of yellow, where it's a thicker, and you can just put your finger on it and slide it in, and you can see that I'm cutting out. I'm going, if you look up at the top, you'll see how it's an 8.9 seconds, and now I'm sliding it over and making it shorter. So what I'm going to do is I'm looking at myself here, and I see that I'm going to try to get it right to where I started, and that would be right about there. So now watch where I push play.
You will not believe.
See, now you see I cut out those 4 seconds of me pushing play, stepping back, looking at the script, and now it opens up with,
you will not believe,
with what I want. Now I'm gonna cut out the backside of that one where I go to cut it out. And I'm just looking at myself. Stop right there.
You will not believe what I'm doing today.
So then, what I would do is, so the little guys in between, this little guy right there that I just highlighted, those are transitions. And when you click on it, you can see at the bottom, it gives you 6 different transition choices. And so for a video like this, so as you can see, this transition piece, the one that's chosen, has kind of like a fade. See how it faded like that?
Oh, yeah.
And I know it's a little choppy on your guys' end, but I would, for this one, because it's supposed to be consecutive, but I'm showing an example of how you can create a video like this and edit it together. I'm going to choose none, which means it's just going to pop into the next scene. So now I gotta re-edit that ending.
And then where do you add words?
So see at the bottom here, you see how you have scissors, and then there's a little this is the speed. This is where you can speed it up or slow it down just by toggling this guy right here. I can put myself in slow-mo or fast. This guy right here is the sound. So if I want to turn myself down or turn myself up, and then the T is for text. And so then it opens up these options, and I can just choose one. And then what it's going to do is it's going to pop it.
That's so cool.
Yeah, it's going to pop it right into the middle. But if you notice down, look down below where the text options are, and you see center and lower. So I can move that right there, or I can keep it in the center of the screen.
Got it.
So you can play around with these different fonts and different choices of text, basically. And it's kind of fun, and you can play around with it. And then over here is filters. I don't usually do filters, but as you can see, I know the ladies in the group, most ladies that I know like to play with filters. I know my wife does and my daughters do. So you can do filters. And then when you want to add music, so I think you get the basis on editing here. And I'm happy to send you guys the script that I use for this. And if you guys want to practice with this, by all means, do it. It's a great exercise. You don't have to post it if you don't want, but the script is designed to be a video you could post to social to basically say, I'm learning how to edit videos. Watch out, world. And it's just a way to brand yourself. So it's kind of cool.
Wait, is that?
I'll send David the script so he can share it with you.
Okay.
One more thing I'll show you. See the little plus sign up here below the big screen at the top? So if you hit that plus sign, it pops up this screen. So either A, I can add another image that I forgot or something like that, or I can click audio, which takes me to these options. And soundtracks is the iMovie music. So it's all non-licensed stuff. And you can just click on one and listen to it. So it's this kind of stuff. It's like elevator music.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
Yep, you have all those options. And then you have sound effects, so you can choose various sound effects. I can put a barking dog. It's the same concept then. So then if I did that, if I took audio, let's just say I took the barking dog, push plus, which drops it in there. And then if I want, I can, so I put it right there. I may not have wanted it right there. So you really want to, want to go to the point in the video where you want the barking dog. And if I put music, it would overlay the entire thing. And then you can cut it to different places. Cause sometimes I'll start with music, then I'll talk, then I'll end with music. And you can do all that. All of this can be done in iMovie. David knows how to do all this stuff. So I would just recommend honestly getting with them, but it's so easy. It's so usable. That anybody can do this. And so, like I said, I'll share the script with David. I'll also share a copy of this, of the presentation. I'll send you guys a view only. So that way you can watch the videos. If they were choppy, you can see what I mean and just kind of give yourself ideas. I'm going to continue to create this stuff, because I love it. And I love teaching agents, how they can do better. And I have kind of a creative mind, so I enjoy it. While we're here, I'll take you into TikTok real quick.
Jeff, sorry. Before you go in there, Mindy, if you remember when we shot those open house videos a couple of years ago.
That was the best movie.
Yeah, they were cool. They were done in when Jeff went into iMovie and he
selected the trailer.
Yeah. When you do a trailer, it tells you exactly what you need. So it's really easy. It walks you through, hey, take a landscape shot, take a portrait shot, take a 2-second video, and it makes it like idiot proof. That's how I was able to do that. It totally makes it idiot proof. So we did that. That video took us 15-20 minutes.
Yeah.
And we just changed the copy. So that's a quick, easy way to do a.
That was so cool. Jeff, I'm totally guilty of being that realtor that every single time I'm on video, no matter what I'm doing, hi guys. I can't help it. It's just I do a little show. It's called Mindy's Corn Tour of Houses. What could I do to keep people, like, how would I start something like that?
What's your next video going to be about? Or what was your last video about?
What I do is I show a house at, I kind of do a walkthrough with people. It's on Zoom through Facebook Live. And I always start it off with, hi guys, I can't help it. So it's called Mindy's Corn Tour of Houses, like grab your quarantini.
It's easy. Every house has a unique feature. So whatever that feature is of the house, that's what I would lead in with. So I would lead in with a question of, could you see yourself in a house with an awesome backyard pool or with an awesome view of the ocean or with whatever, you know, question. Or I would say, you should see, so it's a bold statement, like you should see the completely redone kitchen in this house. Hey, it's Mindy, and I'm, you know, with whatever your show's called.
Okay.
So every one of them, just fight the urge. And like I said, it's all about preparation. So if you go in prepared and you just beat it in your own head and just practice. And that's why when you learn how to do, if you're going live, that's one thing. It's a little bit more challenging. That just takes practice as well. But if you're shooting these videos yourself and editing them yourself, you can mess up 10 million times, no matter how much time you have. But that's the beauty of it. That's why I encourage people to learn how to do this.
Yeah. Okay, good.
Cool. David, do you want me to jump in TikTok real quick and show you a couple quick things?
Good with me if everyone's got time.
Yeah, I do. I'd love to see that.
I too would love it.
All right, cool.
I did a dance, but I wouldn't show you guys. It was pretty bad.
So the thing about TikTok, and I'm not going to get too deep because there's a million features. And so what you're literally seeing, like, this is what I'm looking out at outside my window here in my office at home. And so on this screen here, you see there's a ton of stuff. So what I did was, I'm going to go back. So this is my feed, right? And I click the little plus. You're not seeing that. Hold on. Did I freeze on you guys?
Yeah, you did. Are you good now? I think
you're good now. Hold on. Okay, yeah. Now, you see me moving?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
So all I did was push the plus sign to start a new video, right?
And you're frozen.
Okay. Can you, but the screen's frozen though, right?
Yeah.
Here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put it down so it's a black screen because I think it just
came. Your audio's gone.
Is it black?
Not black, but now it's more fluid. It was like I couldn't hear you and then the screen froze.
Okay, so this is what I want. I want it to be a black screen. I'm blocking my camera right now. But you can see the features of TikTok, right? You seeing that or no? I might be on overload for Zoom right now.
Yeah.
Okay. You know what I can do? I could actually, I could record a video just to show you some of the features. Because what I really, what I wanted to show you was when you're shooting a video, and what are you seeing right now on my screen? Here, let me do this. Let me stop it. Let me reshare it. All right, what do you got?
Full screen.
Black screen.
Black screen, you're frozen.
Okay, good. I'm gonna keep it that way because I don't wanna mess around. I just wanna show you these features. So you can see here, okay. Can you see, does my, you see my cursor moving?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay, so here's a couple things I just wanna quickly show you is that, actually this is blocking it. There, I'll move that. You can see down here, you have the choice to choose 15 or 60 seconds. Most TikToks are 15 seconds, but in some cases you're gonna shoot something that's 60 seconds. It automatically defaults to 15. So this one is defaulted to 15. Next, you can shoot these videos in different speeds. That's getting super aggressive. I would just leave it at 1x. I wouldn't mess around with anything. Obviously you see effects here. You can play with effects. I'm not gonna get into that. What I want to show you is, though, up here on this right side here, the most important thing is this little timer right here. So what this is what happens is when you shoot a TikTok, you push this little button here. Like if I'm shooting a video, let's just say of my kids, I push the red button and look at the top. See how the blue thing is toggling across? That's telling me how much of the video is going right now. So I can stop it. And then I can restart another scene. Boom, stop it, go to another scene. So this is just very basic stuff, and I can click this X right here to go back. I didn't like that scene, I'm gonna get rid of it. I can do it on my phone. I'm gonna discard the last clip, I'm gonna discard that clip, I'm gonna discard the whole thing. Very basic stuff, again, don't get overwhelmed here, but what I wanna show you is, a lot of people ask, and I ask this question, okay, when I'm shooting a video, I have to hold that red button, so how do I shoot videos of myself? The answer is you hit the little timer here. So this guy right here, watch what happens. It pops this up. You see this at the bottom there? So now you see there's a 3 and 10 second countdown. So let's just say, David, for example, I did that basketball video yesterday. If you guys didn't see it, it's on Instagram or go follow me on TikTok. I shot that all myself with no help. I used my tripod and I had to set my camera up, press play, run to a spot and shoot a hoop, right? So the way you do that is I can toggle this and say, okay, I know that the first scene is gonna be about 2 seconds because I know I'm gonna do about 10 scenes and each, I got 15 seconds, so I'm gonna make them about 2 seconds. So I move this little red cursor to 2 seconds, right? Then I can set 3 or 10 second countdown. So I push play and then boom, my video is counting down. I can run to my spot, get in place. I can shoot my hoop or whatever I wanted to do. So watch what happens. Videoing, stop. Because it stopped at 2 seconds because I told it what I wanted it to do. So there's my first image. Then I click the timer again and say, okay, I want to get my next segment's gonna be another 2 seconds. So I was at 2.2, I'm gonna go to about 4. And I'm gonna give myself 10 seconds again, or you can go 3. So 3 seconds is just a shorter timer if you don't need as much room. I'm gonna press play, countdown. It's videoing me. 1, 2 seconds, done. There's my next image. So you can see how, like David, for that basketball video, that's how I created it. And you just use this timer, and that's how you shoot it for yourself. And you can just toggle to how long you want it to shoot. Or like the one I did where I was running up the stairs displaying what the mortgage rates were doing, same concept. I had to give myself a 10 second countdown because I had to get in place. And then as soon as it counted down, I'd have to run. And don't get me wrong, sometimes you have to shoot and reshoot these to get these right. Once you get the hang of it, even though that happens because you got to time it just right, this is how you do it. It's absolutely fascinating. You're not going to learn this stuff just by me showing you today, but I just wanted to show you because this is one of the things I struggled with for so long. It's like, how in the hell are these people creating these videos? And then once I got my daughters to actually sit down and showed me, I was absolutely blown away. And so basically you could do that for an entire video. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and delete that out and get rid of it. But that's all I'll give you today. Honestly, I have yet to figure out a way, I haven't tried, but I gotta get out of TikTok. I have yet to figure out a way to teach someone how to use TikTok. That's about the only way I can do it without being together. I think if I was with you, I could easily display it because I could actually shoot a TikTok and show you exactly the steps I went through. But until I can, I feel like I need to become more of an expert before I can teach you. But I just wanted to show you that because you guys can go in and play around. You can shoot video. You can take a video off your phone and upload it into TikTok. I did that last night with this video right. Oh, you're not looking at my screen. But I took a video on my phone and uploaded it and then just added some text. I can add music to it. You can do that too while you're playing around. The filter features are absolutely nuts. There's so many things. You can do split screen. There can be nine of you. There can be all kinds of effects on your video. It's, as you can tell, I get excited about this stuff because it's pretty damn cool. So that's all I got. We're at an hour and a half. Surprised you guys stuck with me this long.
It's good stuff. I love it.
Can I ask one quick question?
Yeah.
Is it possible to download the TikTok videos to your computer and then edit them with iMovie?
You wouldn't need to. Okay. So TikTok's editing features are way more advanced than iMovie. So there's no reason to do that. And that's where you just don't understand the features of TikTok. Because once you learn the editing features of TikTok, you realize that iMovie is like kindergarten and TikTok's like a doctorate. And when it comes to editing, it's that different. It's that advanced. So you wouldn't need to. So the only thing you would potentially do is edit a movie in iMovie and then upload it to TikTok because you wanted to add licensed music, for example. That would be one way you can do it. And that's something I do. And sometimes I'll just take a video of my kid and it just turned into a cool video that I think it needs good music. And so I literally will put it in TikTok because I can add better graphics. So you notice the graphics in iMovie are just words, but in TikTok, it can be colored. It can be, it's so much more. And you can adjust like where they are on the screen. And iMovie, you can't do that. It's either middle or bottom on TikTok, you can do whatever you want. So it's,
Did you say iMovie, you can add music?
You can, but you can only add iMovie music, which is non-licensed music. It's just elevator type music, which is fine. But if you want to add like a popular hip hop song or country song or whatever, a Beach Boys song, whatever, in TikTok, whatever is in TikTok's library, you can use and you can share it to Facebook and Instagram and you will not get muted. But if you did that on iMovie, or InShot, like that example that I shared with you that had the music in the listing video, if I shared that to Facebook, I would get muted and you wouldn't be able to hear it because they would say that music's licensed.
Wow.
And on top of that, you can search by the lyrics too. So like I did to mess around with TikTok last night, I had a bunch of clips of Cooper, my little one, throwing a football. And I mashed like five or six clips together and I trimmed them just so it was the motion of this and I didn't get all the running and the whatever. And then I searched for Tom Brady and I added some song that's some rap hip hop song that's something Tom Brady. And so when he's throwing the football, it's Tom Brady, Tom Brady, Tom Brady. But it picked up the lyrics. The name of the song, I don't think, is Tom Brady. I thought that was pretty cool.
That's cool. It's really amazing. And actually, David, I even was watching that video and I was thinking to myself, some of the filters and effects you could have done with that would have been so cool. It's just so hard. Like I said, it's so advanced that I don't want to overwhelm people because a lot of people come to me and say, teach me TikTok. And I say, how well do you understand iMovie? And the answer is usually not very well. And so I'm like, let's crawl before we walk. And right. So like, David, I could teach you TikTok. But you need to have an understanding of editing first before you'll understand how to use a platform like TikTok. And it's amazing because our kids, anybody who's like 5 to 20, they're just born with the ability to understand how to do this stuff. It's crazy. It's frustrating as hell. But it's the world we live in now. And so it's take advantage of your kids, your grandkids, your neighbor's kids, your sisters and brother's kids, because they can teach you this stuff. And in a lot of cases, they enjoy teaching it. So when you're at the next function and you ask the teenager in the room, do you do TikTok, and say, can you show me some cool things? Do it. Because they will blow your mind. And they're not very good at teaching, because I can tell you from experience, my daughters used to get they're always like, here, just hand me the phone. And I'm like, no, damn it. I want to learn how to do this. And so it's, but it's really amazing.
Awesome.
Michael had a question. Michael, I think that was in regards to, you said you have to delete and reshoot a segment if you didn't like the end of it instead of editing it. Yeah. In TikTok, yeah. You don't actually edit it. You just delete that shot, which happens all the time. Okay. So you go in sequential. So you can't go back. So if I shot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and I got to 5 and decided I didn't like 2, I have to delete 5, 4, 3, 2 to get back to it.
Right.
Do it sequentially, basically.
Yeah. I was just thinking how you were saying how, you know, how you would go in and like, if you're, how you were hitting the stop button with your hand. So if like maybe the end of the video, you didn't like it was too long and you wanted to cut the end part of it. You can't do that. You just have to cut the whole segment out and start over.
Yes. Okay. It's totally different in the sense that you have to, instead of editing piece, you have to get the timing just right. So it's David. Remember I shared that one yesterday or the other day with you over the weekend of that guy that looked like he was flying. I'm still going to show you that one. I'm going to have to shoot that 15 second video in like half second increments. So basically it's somebody jumping, but all you see is the jumping, is my legs flapping. And then if I put it all together, it looks like I'm floating through the air. Mm-hmm. And to do that in iMovie would be probably near impossible, but to do it in TikTok, it's totally doable. It'll probably take me 30 minutes to do, and I'll probably be sweating my ass off when I'm done. but it'll be cool as hell. And you can't create that stuff unless you have some really amazing editing skills. And that's where TikTok's just, again, it continues to blow my mind. I try not to get stuck in the rabbit hole because it is the rabbit hole of all rabbit holes. It is so freaking entertaining. I get on it usually late at night when I'm laying in bed and my wife's like, yeah, I pretty much lost you now because all you do is watch TikTok. And I'm like, yeah, I have to like put it down because it sucks you in. And, but it's what makes it so cool.
Awesome.
Yep.
Is TikTok almost like its own little social media?
It is. Yeah, it is. Except it plays really nicely with all the platforms, which is so cool. They're smart. You know, this is a Chinese app. And so I'm not going to go down that rabbit hole of conspiracies, but they're smart. And that platform plays very nicely with Facebook, Instagram. It's not really YouTube content. And actually, YouTube does mute those videos. So I don't even bother putting them on YouTube. Plus, YouTube doesn't like 15-second videos. It wants 5-minute videos. But I'll tell you what, I get more engagement, organic engagement on IG, especially Instagram, on my TikTok videos. I'll get 2,000 and 3,000 views, which is insane. That's hard to do on Instagram. And people just love it. They want to consume it. And so again, going back to last week, I'm playing the algorithm game. So the more content that drives more eyeballs, it means my content's going to be showing up in their feeds more often. So I'm just always trying to figure out what does my audience want to see. And it's not me talking about mortgages or talking about real estate. It's me creating TikToks. It's me showing my daughter. It's me showing my dogs. It's me showing my travel. It's whatever. Me working out. That's what my audience wants. So I give it to them. And that's what you all have to figure out. Like what are my passions? Like you were just talking about cooking. That's a phenomenal piece of content. Like you could literally just create perpetual content on cooking. Like everybody likes it. Doesn't matter if you're a health nut or you could care less. We all love to watch food videos. It's just, it's a part of us. It's a part of our fibers of our being. So I think food is a great one.
What's a good video to put on YouTube?
Digital mayor strategy is the best for YouTube. So the agents that I know that are crushing it the most focus on local content. And so they'll do, when it's real estate specific, it's usually less house specific, although they will do like listing videos on YouTube, but they'll do like community videos, like a video about a subdivision or a video about a new builder that's about ready to start it. Or they'll do a video about local parks that you could go to. Like, hey, I'm here at Whatchacallit Park today. And this is just such an awesome park for kids. It has a playground. And then you do various cuts and you show around the park and you show the trails. And that's good YouTube content because it's all, you got to remember, YouTube is the number 2 search engine in the world next to Google. Google owns YouTube. So the content on YouTube is SEO content. It's search engine optimization content. So you want to create content that people might be searching for. So for example, get inside the head of your potential buyers. Somebody moving to West Palm Beach, what are they Googling? Are they Googling local parks for my kids? Are they Googling local schools? Are they Googling best beaches to go to? So literally, there's so much content. You could come up with 5 years worth of content just on West Palm or just on Wellington, just to highlight what's going on in the community. You could interview businesses, everything. I mean, really, YouTube favors 5 to 10 minute content. So that's what you want. And you want it to be SEO driven. So you want it to be, you know, like your keywords need to be moving to West Palm Beach, parks in West Palm Beach, you know, the best beaches to go to, you know, things like that. That's what you want to create your content around. I shared last week an image of three of the agents that I find probably the most fascinating. There's a lot of them that do it very well, but these are three that I know personally, and they do a really good job of creating YouTube content. I would just recommend going and checking out their channels, stalk their channels. There's a lot of people doing it at a high level, and it's a blank canvas. There's not enough realtors doing it, and it's really cool stuff. And you know, again, some of them are doing it with professional videographers, and some of them, like Karen Carr, she's in Augusta, Georgia. She shoots the vast majority of her videos with just a cell phone and a tripod. She's got some basic editing skills, but she's done such a good job of putting out so much content around her city and her community that she is the person that pops up on Google searches when people are looking for things to do or searching to move to her town. And she just comes up, so she becomes that, you know, that expert, that authority. I could share that image, David, too. Just remind me of what you need me to share with you after this, and I'll share it.
All right, any other questions, guys? No?
All right,
well, you guys know where to find me. If you have any other questions or need help editing, you guys know I'm always here for you as a resource. And I think I sent out a video about the forbearance stuff today. I'm not going to go into it again, but let me know if you have questions on that. And Jeff, thank you so much for coming on. Definitely. I mean, you spent almost 2 hours with us. That was amazing. So thank you very much. I hope you guys all got something out of it, one little nugget that can help your business at least. I'm sure there's more than that, but I'm definitely going to, you're going to see some TikToks from me coming out in the next week or so. Yeah. So
and I'll
to go play on my iMovie. I'm going to give it a try.
Jeff.
And thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
All right, man. Thank you so much. Appreciate it, Jeff.
Bye, guys.
Take care, guys.
Bye, guys.
Bye, Mandy. You shouldn't even take that right.
Thanks for coming on, Sean, Michael.
Next time.
Bye. Thank you.